Hi and welcome to MTB Cooking. Today we share with you how to barbecue crispy pork shanks. So we make them on a barbecue, in this case a Weber charcoal grill, but you could use a gas grill as well. First of all, we will start to heat up half a portion of really good charcoals. And I say really good charcoals, it could be heat beads for instance, so some charcoals that will stay hot for a long time. What you see here is our pork shanks. We've taken some good quality pork shanks. These are organic. And what we have done is that we have just very nicely cleansed these in drizzling cold water. And then we will actually take a sharp knife and cut sort of crisscross all over the pork shank and get down to the flesh. So it's important to actually go through the rind on these pork shanks. This will ensure that we can have the skin puff up nicely and go crispy when grilled or when barbecued. Then we take a neutral tasting oil. We've used canola oil in this case. And we're gonna rub it nicely into the skin before rubbing a good amount of coarse salt into the skin as well. And this will also help to really puff up the skin, that's for sure. We are now pouring these hot charcoals into the side baskets where we've already placed half a portion, that means the same amount as we have heated up, of non-lit charcoals. So this means that the hot charcoals will start to light up the non-lit ones, and then we can actually keep a higher temperature for a longer time in the grill. We have added just a recipient in the bottom of the grill with a bit of water in it so we can create some steam in the grill. And then we're actually going to place the shanks on the grill on top. And the idea with the steam is that the meat will go nice and tender and not become dry when there is steam in the closed environment in the barbecue. We're just using these small balls of aluminum foil to help the shank stand nicely and not fall over when we close the lid. And what is really cool about this way of doing it is that the grill will stay really hot for around 3 hours. We're counting on having the temperature of 200 degrees Celsius or 390 degrees Fahrenheit. It's important to leave the dampers open both in top and bottom of the grill, so it'll really make the charcoals heat up as much as possible. This is just looking at the shanks during the cooking time, but we gave them 1 hour and 30 minutes in this position on the grill. And we did that at indirect heat, meaning that the shanks are not directly above the charcoals. And in this case, they won't get burnt, but they'll still get the benefits of the very hot environment. What we're doing here is that we're turning the shanks over, so after the 1.5 hours, to have more of the skin facing downwards and become even more crispy. And then we gave them another 1 hour and 30 minutes. After that, we're actually finished. We have grilled our shanks and they're nicely done, crispy, as you can hear, and just ready to be eaten. And we of course recommend you to serve them up as quickly as possible so that they're really nice and hot for serving. We can assure you that the crispy skin is very important to serve along with the meat because it is so insanely satisfying with this salty, crispy skin and then the tender meat underneath. We served up just with a bit of coleslaw, nothing fancy, but you could of course make a sauce or something with the juices that have gathered in the recipient in the bottom of the grill, for instance. You could make an amazing sauce. But what you can see here is that it's guaranteed tender meat. It has cooked for 3 hours in a really hot grill on indirect heat. But there has been the steam in the grill from the water that we put in the bottom, and that has just helped us getting this meat that is not dry at all, that is, on the other hand, very, very tender, very, very juicy. And such a simple method of cooking can actually turn something so simple into something so delicious. Thanks a lot for watching MTB Cooking on YouTube. We're happy to have you with us. Please give this video a like, subscribe to our channel if you haven't done so already, and then we'll see you next time in a new video. Bye!